Good afternoon. Welcome to the next episode of Reach Out. I'm here. Today I want to touch upon the topic about grief. Simply put, a loss of near one family member, something close to you. That's a natural response, grief. About 5 to 10% of the annual population goes through the grief of losing a family member, but it can and it is attributed over many things. Grief can be for loss of a pet for many people, a major change in life like retirement, move location, divorce, kids leaving home, separation from a lover, and something which people will resonate a lot in the current times, loss of a job, income, or position. And that hits you, because forget coping up with it, you just cannot digest the fact that how are you going to manage things with that grief around you. How are you going to manage without that loved one in your life? How are you going to manage without the job? Without that fixed income on which basis you had planned your future? How are you going to manage without that position which you had built so successfully over such a period of time with your hard work? And suddenly it's gone. And to no avail. And quite a few people take different mechanisms to try to cope with it, but not necessarily it's instant. Many a times people avoid accepting grief. Acknowledgement is the first and foremost thing which is required in this. People will avoid emotions, they will get into compulsive behaviors, they will get into substance abuse, which is so common. And then eventually substance abuse leads to physical abuse. They just take time to relate to the healing process. And that is something which everyone needs to resonate, needs to reach out to people on that, with that healing process. We need to acknowledge first and foremost and accept both positive and negative feelings about grief, about the loss of the situation, about the loss in our lives. We have to allow time. That time to accept, to experience the thoughts, the feelings, to cope with those negative feelings, that negative experience. And thirdly, we need to confide in that one person or couple of people whom we are close to in terms of friends or family. You could be that one person. You could be that friend or family with only two words: I'm here. You never know whose life you might save, whose grief you could share and spread positivity, and then see the miracle of life. Thank you.